Professor Sean Munson, University of Washington, thank you very much for being with me. You've come up with a kind of a breakthrough application. Tell me about how the work got started and what you've come up with balance.
For me, it started as a very personal motivation. Starting in high school, I was a political blogger for a while and through college, and it was fun. And then sometime after the 2004 election, I woke up and said, wait, I'm having a conversation only with people who already agree with me, and making them a little more energized, a little bit angrier. But my hopes when I started it was to learn more and also to have sort of a dialogue with people who might not agree with me. And that wasn't really happening. So I stopped. Actually, was kind of like, wait, this totally wasn't what I wanted. So I deleted the whole blog. But then through the guidance of some of my undergraduate professors, started shaping this as a question of, okay, but how could the internet live up to that potential? Are there ways that it might, rather than just sort of moping about what went wrong or throwing it all away? So I was very fortunate to go off to the University of Michigan for grad school and work with an advisor who had similar interests. Balancer is a new project where it's a plugin for your Chrome web browser. It installs a character who hangs out in the upper right corner of your browser. And depending on the bias or the slant of the news you're reading, it will lean a little bit left or a little bit right, or it'll be balanced. And as you lean further, you'll get more recommendations for sites that might help you balance out your news consumption. This is an early tool. It's reflective and helps you see whether or not you're living up to your own norms or what your own beliefs are about how balanced the news you're reading is or how biased it is. And using that, we're learning a lot more about how people read news, and hopefully this will also help us build better tools. So it's the first step.
What are these sites? What do they contain, and who uses them?
Yeah, so we're classifying a whole bunch of news websites, your own, I believe, as well as several of the major news outlets like MSNBC, CNN, Fox News, New York Times. And then on some of those sites, we're classifying particular columnists whose opinions may not lean quite the same way as the major editorial opinions for that site. In addition to that, we're classifying a bunch of sites that are blogs that are run by professional pundits, by people who are really interested in it, and just people who sort of want somewhere to write about politics online, as well as some of the sites put together by interest groups, political action committees, or candidates. If we look at sites that are like news aggregators, for example, some of the studies from Pew Research have found that these are becoming increasingly important for how Americans access news among a certain demographic. Gets nearly 70% of Americans are using them day to day among a certain age group. So increasingly people are turning here when they do look for news, and sometimes they're reading in depth, sometimes they're skimming. But we wanted to capture sort of the holistic view of the political news that people are encountering online.
So the aggregator is choosing information from the New York Times or the PBS NewsHour, but also from columnists and writers and others who may have a particular bent. Are they trying to balance, or are you finding they aren't doing a good enough job of balancing political perspective, ideology?
Yeah, so I'm trying not to get prescriptive about how one should write their own news, right? And I think that sites that present balanced or more balanced opinions have their place, as well as sites that take a particular editorial perspective. But what I think is important is that when someone reads news, they don't read from just one bucket or another, but that they do encounter viewpoints that might differ from their own. There's a lot of work that says that when people encounter challenging opinions, they learn more, they solve problems better. If their preferred policy solution wasn't chosen, they might understand why it's not chosen, at least be tolerant or understanding of it, rather than creating some conspiracy theory about how something was stolen from them or how the other side stole the election or passed a bill in the dead of night. And I think that it's really important for an informed citizenship to help us make informed better decisions as a country, and also to understand when decisions that we don't agree with might still be chosen.
Do you believe that the kind of consumption of website political news and information that's out there has contributed to what many people agree is the most partisan political atmosphere in anyone's memory?
I think it can. I think there's, you know, a positive relationship between each. So when you end up with a very partisan environment, people are probably more likely to seek out things that reaffirm their sort of opinions about their viewpoint or their party. And then that feeds back into a more partisan dialogue as well. So I think there's sort of this cycle in which they're interrelated. And to the extent that we can all step out of our own worldview or our own preferences and read and try and understand and show a little empathy for viewpoints that aren't our own, I think it can help us have better discussions about candidates, about ballot initiatives, and about issues.
How do your subjects react to being given that information?
Yeah, so one thing we do is we only give the information in aggregate. So it's sort of your overall trends so that you can seek to correct it on sort of a week-to-week basis. We're not saying don't go read that really strongly opinionated piece. We're just trying to say, in aggregate, try and read from multiple sides or some sort of balance, or at least giving you information so that you can. We've gotten a lot of really good emails and online conversations, actually, with people who have tried out the extension. Some of them have pointed out times when our classifier doesn't do well and it gets an article or a site wrong, and they've helped us improve those classifications. A lot of people have told us that they're using it to help them try and find more balanced news, or even if they don't want to change their behavior, they just want to know their own behavior. I was surprised when I first started using it just how unbalanced my own reading was. And I'm someone who tries to read fairly, you know, diverse viewpoints. And so I think just having a tool that lets us reflect on, am I living up to my own ideals, whatever my own goals are, it might be useful for people.
Well, Sean Munson, PhD, professor, University of Washington, with a new browser plugin called Balance that tells us which way our reading is leaning. Good luck, and we'll check back with you as you gather more information.
Thanks.